So I thought it would be great to make a video of why I don't short stocks. With the recent GameStop craziness that went on in the market, people are talking a lot about shorting stocks. It's not something I do, but let's talk about why. Coming up next. Everybody, my name is Dee Burks, and this is Retirement Rescue, where we talk about how to make money, save money, and create a retirement from nothing. Well, here lately, the stock market has been a crazy, crazy place. The GameStop incident that where all the Redditors got together and the hedge funds lost a lot of money because all the little guys went up against the big guys. Well, basically, that whole situation brought up the conversation about shorting stocks. As an investor, you can buy stocks in a regular fashion, which is long. You buy a stock, it goes up or down, and you sell it. If it goes up, you make money. If it goes down and you sell it, you lose money. Simple deal. You buy, you sell. When we're talking about shorting stocks, you're doing just the opposite. You are selling a stock thinking that stock will go down. And if it goes down, you buy it back in and you make money on the difference. It's basically just backwards of a regular stock transaction. And there's nothing wrong with that per se. You make money going up, you make money going down. Where it really got convoluted here recently is the idea that a lot of these large hedge funds are engaged in very, very speculative shorting of stocks. They're shorting more stocks than are even out there to buy, and then they're trying to manipulate the market by putting out reports, by going on media and saying, "Oh, this stock is terrible," and they're trying to force the price down. And that's really market manipulation is what it is. And the little guys basically got tired of it. And they could tell that was going on, so they did just the opposite. They made the stock price go up because they were buying, buying, buying. And those big guys lost millions. But when you think about shorting stocks, there is one main reason I don't do it. It has nothing to do with is it okay or not. Of course, it's okay. It's one tactic, one strategy out of many that you can use when you're investing. But I like to bet on winners. When you're shorting a stock, you are betting on that company to lose. You're betting on them to fold. You're betting on that stock price to crash. I don't like betting on someone else's demise. And really, people like to say, "Oh, well, it doesn't matter. These companies don't." Those companies are people. Those are people's jobs. And those companies, yes, maybe at the end of their life cycle, they may be Kmart or Kodak or someone who's spiraling, circling down the drain. But I don't want to make money on their demise. That's just me personally. I like to invest in a different way. The cool thing about investing is that you get to decide what kind of investor you are. If you want to just invest in stocks that are all about clean energy or socially responsible companies, you can choose to do that. That's your choice, and you get to decide. I personally like to pick stocks that are on their way up. They're companies that are either building something, producing something, creating patents for something, creating new therapies and drugs, creating something that is good. Those companies who are the next Amazon that you can buy now for $2 and 3 or 4 years from now, maybe $500 stocks. That's what I like to do. I like to bet on winners. But that does not mean anyone else's strategy for investing is invalid. And I would never tell them that. I mean, Warren Buffett likes to invest in big companies like Coca-Cola. He has made billions doing it. I don't want to invest in Coca-Cola. I don't care. I don't even drink carbonated beverages anymore because, hey, I'm over 50 and it gives me heartburn. But the point here is you don't have to invest in every single thing. You don't have to invest in every single strategy. In fact, just the opposite. If you try doing too many different things and too many different types of investment strategies, odds are you'll lose money. The reason being you don't really get good at any one of them. And that's the true secret. There are a lot of things I don't invest in. I don't invest in precious metals. I don't invest in currency. I don't, at this stage of the game, invest in commodities. You can invest in any of those things. But I am focusing on what I'm doing because I want to get really good at it. And I want to be very profitable. And really, if you're going to invest, isn't that the point? To make a profit, to be able to add to your retirement income. That's my goal. That's my only goal. And so it's really important to me to make money doing that. It's not important to me to invest in everything that everyone else is investing in. And it really shouldn't be to you either. Because your strategy and mine is all about creating that retirement income, creating that security for yourself. So decide who you want to be as an investor and then learn to invest using that strategy. Now, once you get good at it, yes, you may expand into different things, into currency or metals or whatever, but get good at it first. But even when I go to other strategies at some point in the future, I'm still going to choose the ones that are positive, the ones that are really doing things that are helpful and productive and produce things. I'm not going to invest in companies that tear things down, that destroy people, that destroy companies, and I just won't do it. It may be a very simplistic way of looking at it, and I guess it is, but I don't care. I get to choose. So do you. And my investment strategy is going to be positive and forward thinking. I really believe that's where the money's at. And I want to take part and invest in the success of those companies that are creating a great future for everybody. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, please click subscribe, and I'll see you next time.